Hi, this is Julian from MinuteEarth. This shrub is super metal. No, literally, it's a rare metal-hoarding plant whose bluish-green sap, when dried out, is 25% nickel. That's 10 times more nickel than the typical nickel-containing ore found in nickel mines. In fact, these plants are actually planted in abandoned nickel mines to take the leftover nickel out of the soil, which keeps the toxic metals from leaching into waterways and makes the land viable for other uses like farming. And these metal-hoarding plants are even planted in particularly nickel-rich land, then harvested and processed to extract enough metal to return a profit. All plants are able to take some metals up from the soil. After all, they're used in crucial tasks. Nickel, for instance, is a critical part of plants' nitrogen cycle. But most plants contain less than 0.0005% nickel, and similar levels of other metals. Any more than that is usually toxic. Surplus nickel inhibits cell division and harms the chlorophyll needed for photosynthesis in leaves, all leading to very dead plants. So, how do metal hoarders survive with 50,000 times the normal amount? And what do they do with it? This isn't just a matter of the plants passively absorbing more metal from nutrient-packed soil. Metal hoarding plants actively suck in way more metal than normal, and they do so by making a lot more of the special proteins that plants use to take in specific nutrients from the soil. Similar proteins transport the metal up into the leaves and trap it in cordoned off pockets within leaf cells, helping the plant wondrously evade death. Okay, but why the heck do they slurp up so much nickel if they're just going to pack it away? Maybe other hoarders can give us a clue, like the salt-loving plants that use this same mechanism to hoard salt, another nutrient that generally kills plants at high concentrations. As it turns out, all that hoarded salt attracts more water from the soil, so salt hoarding is a great adaptation for plants living in drought-prone areas. Meanwhile, metal hoarders use precious plant energy to collect a bunch of metal that seems to just sit there doing nothing. Or does it? Scientists believe these super metal plants are, perhaps unsurprisingly, super toxic to some herbivores, which learn to avoid eating them. So plants that can take up toxic metals and survive become toxic themselves without having to expend energy to concoct their own defensive toxins. So if you want to be left alone, just turn up the metal.